Hey guys, welcome to PIVX Class. Today we're shaking things up a little bit. For a while I've put aside certain topics because there wasn't really enough to talk about to make a full episode. We can spend 6 to 10 minutes talking about ZPOS, but we can't spend much more than 3 talking about block time. Then I thought, is there a rule that I can't make more than 1 video per week? So some weeks, instead of releasing a regular episode or a why cryptocurrency episode, we are going to release 2 or sometimes maybe 3 short format episodes. We'll just call this series Explained Super Fast. We can even go back and do some former topics in this format because some people may want their definitions more bite-sized. They also have the potential of being more useful for inserting into other conversations or other works to define certain topics. We'll also cut down the beginning and end chatter to shorten the episodes even more. So this will probably actually be the longest Explained Super Fast we'll ever make. But anyways, today is block time, Explained Super Fast. Okay, block time. Blocks on a blockchain are spaced out to complete at certain intervals of time. In the case of Bitcoin, blocks are 10 minutes apart. The current block gets all the new Bitcoin transactions recorded on it. After approximately 10 minutes, the block gets verified and a new one begins off the history of the previous blocks. An important thing to pay attention to here is the approximately. Block times are not fixed. There is no actual clock deciding when a block will be verified. What is actually happening is the miners of Bitcoin are competing to be the one to verify the block. The mining difficulty of Bitcoin is adjusted to make it so that a block is solved roughly every 10 minutes. So one block might take 9 minutes and another block might take 11 minutes, but when you average it all out, it boils down to about 10 minutes. Not all block times are the same though. Bitcoin is just the most well-known example out there. Block times are different between different cryptocurrencies. To name a few, PIVX has a 1 minute block time. Ethereum has a block time of 15 seconds. Dash has a 2.5 minute block time, Zcash has the same as Dash, and Monero is 2 minutes. The reason for choosing a specific block time can vary. For a new entrant to crypto, block time generally affects you by speeding up or slowing down how long it takes for your transactions to be confirmed. Many exchanges, for instance, require 3 confirmations for Bitcoin transactions to be applied to your account. Each confirmation requires the verification of a block. So your Bitcoin transaction takes 30 minutes. That being said, some coins do have features to negate those wait times. Exactly how can differ from coin to coin, but keep an eye out for those features when looking up different coins. And that's it. Block time is just the time period a block occurs over. It is governed by the time it takes for a miner or a staker, for those proof of stake coins out there, to validate a block. Be sure to leave the video a like and share it around. Thank you for tuning in. As always, I love having you here, and I will see you in the next PIVX class.